This is a single 3D print living spring vise printed in ABS on a high dollar 3D printer. Can I print the same thing in PLA on an Ender 3V2? Will it work? We'll find out on today's Filament Friday. This video is sponsored by PCB Way. PCB prototype the easy way with a full-featured custom printed circuit board prototype service from PCB Way. Filament Friday is also brought to you by these Patreon supporters. In a previous video, I 3D printed this. It's a vise made of PETG and it works really well. I use it to hold circuit boards when I'm soldering, but it's a little bit slow, and when I'm doing small boards that I'm constantly flipping or not that many solder joints, it's a little big and bulky, and like I said, a little bit slow and moving. So I wanted something a little quicker, a little easier to use. And a friend of mine showed me this. In fact, he gave me this one. It's kind of wore out, but this was printed in ABS on a high dollar machine at his work. And he uses it to hold different things, including circuit boards. And this one's still springy enough to hold my little circuit board, and I love it. It works great. So I wanted to see if I could print this same thing, which I did find on Thingiverse, using PLA and Ender 3 V2. Would it work? Would it print? Would the springs break or hold up? And would it just fuse together? Here's the design that I found in Thingiverse. It's the PCB Vise spring loaded by user JupeJupe. It was released March 24th, 2019, but this is the first I've ever seen it. Now in his description, he claims you can print this in PLA. So we'll see if he's right, but he didn't say what printer, and there wasn't much in there as far as settings. So let's find out if the Ender 3 V2 can handle it. So I'm using Cura 4.6 to print this. I'm gonna print it rough at the 0.28, which still comes out pretty good, Ender 3 machine profile. I'm using three walls, which is very typical for, I think that's in my profile. 25% infill, which I don't think it matters a whole lot, but some infill. And then 200 degrees C, so a little bit lower. Typically I go 205, I'm gonna use 200. But 60 millimeters per second, a little bit faster than I normally go. Normally I'm at 50. I think this machine can handle it. And I bumped up the retraction speed to 45 millimeters per second because it can handle it. A stock Ender 3 can't. And then when I slice it, if I scroll through it here, I need to get up to a certain level and you'll start to see where the gap appears. So I get to this 15, 16 layer. You can see it's printing walls, but nothing else. And then the springs appear. So it's designed in to have two layers of gap. So that's what allows us to print and still move. I know some of that's gonna merge, but you can see by default, there's air gap in there. So that should allow these to move. So we'll see how that turns out. And if I scroll all the way up, everything looks pretty good. Now it is gonna take estimated 6 hours and 25 minutes to print, and it came pretty close to that. I think it was a little bit longer, almost 7 hours. If you hover over the eye, it'll give you a detail, and it looks like the outer walls and retraction are taking the most time. So that's why it takes so long. So now let's actually print it. Here's a time lapse of it printing on the Ender 3 V2. I gotta admit, I'm a fan of glass bed and it works really well in this machine. That first layer came out beautifully and it prints really well. I do have some stringing that I need to clean up in my profile, but overall I'm liking the print quality I'm getting out of the V2. To take this off the bed and maybe separate things, I'm gonna use this. It's a painter's knife. It's part of my Filament Friday toolkit. It's very, very handy for this and it's so thin and flexible. It's great for getting underneath prints and popping them off. So let's try it here. Popped off pretty easy, but here's the hard part. I don't want to squeeze this too much and break something. So I want to stop it from fusing. So I want to see if I can get this in there. So it slides right under, kind of just break everything loose, including the center section. Just a little bit tougher. Now let's get this side. Seems to be popping apart pretty good. Not a lot of effort. The only thing I'm worried about is this center section. Did it fuse? And it is a little bit tighter, but I'm able to get the painter's knife in there. Now I gotta get underneath the little handles and go all the way. I think I got it. So let's see. Yep, one side's moving. Now the other side. And it's working. Check that out. I don't see it breaking. I do have a little bit of stringing. I still haven't got that's setting perfectly right on the V2 yet. But this is awesome. So you can print this in PLA. I thought it'd have to be ABS, something, you know, that could stand the flex. and holds a circuit board nice and tight. Wow. I mean, it's got a little bit of wiggle up and down, but you're soldering. You're always pushing it down anyway. This is really, really nice. So now I could actually print a bunch of these if I'm soldering a bunch of boards and make this work. There's a few snags as I move it, but overall, I'd say it's a successful print. The Ender 3 V2 did it. Great spacing. It worked. Now for the real test. Let's try and solder a socket to this board and hold it with this thing. So I inserted a 28-pin socket into the board here. I just bend the outer lead so it's going to hold it upside down. Put it into the spring vise and see if it'll hold it. Now bring in the soldering iron, and let's solder a few pins. It's holding it beautifully. I like it. And I can change the angle. I can do different things with it. So I think this is a winner. I'm going to keep this on the bench. And like I said, I'm probably going to print a few more. This worked really well. I like it. And this circuit board is actually from PCBWay. In fact, most of my circuit boards are from PCBWay. I've used PCBWay to fulfill my Kickstarters that I've done in the past. And I cut out my own circuit board, so I'll get them in bulk and cut them out myself. So there's different ways you can go about it. I highly recommend it. They're not just a sponsor. I'm actually a satisfied customer. Lay it out with whatever software you want. Send them the Cura Profiles, and you can get some low-cost printed circuit boards or volume for a very affordable price. Check them out. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos of projects that are popping up. And if you don't want to miss an episode, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.